This is my fourth time trying Microsoft Windows 11.
What?
Last time I didn't have a pleasant experience. So if you didn't watch my previous video about Windows 11, I recommend to check that out first. But after that, you guys recommended me to try Windows 11 or 10 IoT LTSC, which was already deep bloated by Microsoft, which is interesting considering we don't oftenly see those words in the same sentence.
Nope.
But after using Windows 10 for a few months, I thought to try this officially deep bloated Windows 11. So, hit the intro editor.
Bruh.
So, the most challenging part of installing is activating the LTSC edition. You can't casually purchase the keys for LTSC like other versions of Windows. So the solution is our today's sponsor. Just kidding. How would I get a sponsor with only this many subscribers? Anyways, you actually can purchase LTSC keys from third-party key purchasing websites. I know, it may be a gray market, but you're already using a gray software, so even black chips won't matter.
Arr.
However, even if you have a legitimate key, you can't activate this edition normally like other consumer-grade Windows operating systems, unless you have the full ISO version. In short, you have to get the full ISO version in order to activate it for a lifetime. The reason this full version ISO can't be installed easily because there isn't a reliable website to download that. But what you can download from the official Microsoft website is the evaluation version, which is activated for 90 days. So yeah, it's like a trial version of Windows, but that isn't the end of the tunnel. There is a tutorial about converting the evaluation version to a full non-activated version in YouTube. I'll link the tutorial in the description. This will just convert the Windows edition, not activate the Windows. So this is not any kind of piracy. But after converting, you can activate the Windows IoT LTSC version for a lifetime if you have a key. Yeah, that's a hassle. Now it really feels like it's easier to install Linux instead of doing all this bullshit just to get an official deployed Windows from Microsoft. After installing, it feels absolutely stock. I mean, no Microsoft Store, no Copilot, no other pre-installed apps, and in fact, it's so stock that it doesn't even come with Windows Defender. Like, yeah, that's more than an issue than a perk. And I am genuinely having a hard time to get the Defender back. And yeah, everything else feels fine, and the first thing that I noticed was it's fast. Like, really fast. Really snappy, unlike the previous Windows experience. And the RAM usage? Oh boy, it's only 4 GB at idle. Fully stock, whereas the Pro version was eating 5 to 6 gigabytes of RAM. For no reason. Still, 4 gigabytes aren't a good thing either, at least from a Linux perspective. I wonder what Microsoft actually puts in the Pro version to make it eat 25 to 50% more RAM than the purely stock Windows 11. Oh, I forgot to mention that there is actually no TPM requirements in Windows 11 IoT LTSC. So this version is also suitable for those who are rocking 16 gigs of RAM, a GTX 980 Ti with an Core i7 6700K. Pretty convenient. So after getting a pure stock Windows 11, I started to tweak and customize it a bit, and after setting my workspace and restoring my backups, I started using my PC just like before, and from the browser to the Windows, everything felt snappier than before. So this was my first hands-down experience with Windows 11 IoT LTSC. And from my experience, I can at least say that Windows 11 IoT LTSC is objectively better than Windows 11 Pro. Real quick, more than 95% of you aren't subscribed, and if you like my content, then please subscribe and like the video because I don't use AI to create voice or script. Thanks. Now let's see if those issues are fixed which I faced in Windows 11 Pro. Firstly, the gaming performance, and man, I noticed an immediate improvement. I was playing Halo Infinite lately and it ran buttery smooth, no micro stuttering issues like Windows 11 Pro. 1440p native with medium settings and RT off, it got 130 to 150 FPS in bigger battles with 1% loss of 110 to 120 FPS. And the game I mentioned in my previous video, Xonotic, it got smooth 165 FPS with absolutely no FPS drops. And also in a game named Forza Horizon 3, I got almost like 160 to 190 FPS in Windows 11 IoT LTSC. And I got almost like 155 FPS in Windows 11 Pro. But I didn't test it properly, like it was almost the same settings. So take this result with a pinch of salt. But as far as I remember, the settings were almost the same, or like absolutely the same. Now it's time for some esports title. We'll start with CS2, and CS2 is the only esports game here. It's okay. And CS2 got like 200 to 280 FPS, or sometimes even more, but it depends on the map. And the settings were 1440p medium, and except the shadows were high, and everything else was at medium. So, the gaming issue is solved. Oh, I did forgot to mention that you no longer need an online account in order to install Windows 11 IoT LTSC.
Perfect.
Peace at last. Moving on to the next issue, Bluetooth connection issues, which was a big pain in Windows 11 Pro, which is now fixed. And the CPU temps are just like Windows 10, so this is also fixed. In short, most of the Windows 11 issues are fixed. That's a plus for sure, but I just don't get it. It feels like magic to witness such a huge difference just by debloating Windows. But that doesn't mean it doesn't come with trade-offs. The first and the most obvious trade-off is no Windows Defender. But there is an easy fix. You just have to install the Windows security updates and the Defender will return or install with that update immediately. But that's not all, you can't run any UWP apps or games. Gamebird doesn't exist if that's a thing, and some other minor issues. But most of them could be fixed if you can download the necessary .apex files from a trusted source and you can install those packages through PowerShell. So, should you upgrade to Windows 11 IoT LTSC in order to get security updates? My answer is yes. If you can install or activate Windows 11 IoT LTSC, then of course you should give it a try. So, this is one of the solutions of the Windows 10 end of life issue. Other than some personal window managing and UI issues, everything seems fine to me. But if you ask me what will I do, then I'll move to another OS maybe sometime later, cause that's my job. So, hope you enjoyed your session, and if you did, please like and subscribe, and peace.